Hello there, everybody. Welcome on back to moreshapes.io, the factory management game from hell. Let's get some work done today, right? We cleaned up some stuff last time. I actually, you know, looking back on it, I'm pretty happy with this, to be blunt. It's not the most efficient thing on planet Earth, but I don't even think it needs to, right? We cleaned this up so that it's just looking way, way better. Got two lines going in there. We also, you know, we got the blue and white menagerie thing going on here that is still not incredible, right? But then we also hooked up this system down here to make more of these things. Still not insanely efficient. I think, you know, our pitfall is the fact that our dye creation is not as efficient as it could be. We could probably make a few changes here. Maybe we start with getting a little bit more dye. You know what? I don't even want to do it like that. If we're going to do it, then I want to make it good, right? I want to make it good. So let's actually completely remake a part of this, right? We're going to have color mixer, two space color mixer, two space color mixer, okay? And let's a new upgrade is available. We've done it, dude. An extraction upgrade. Cool. What the heck is that? Okay, just ignore it. Let's get this to be a little bit nicer for us. Because I think that the way that we are currently handling the combining of paint here is bad, okay? I think it's bad. So this is going to come to here. Just like that. This is going to come to here. Just like that. Then you're going to do combination, combination. And they're going to come to here like this into a combination. And they're both going to get sent down equal paths. In fact, why even combine it, to be honest with you? They can each run their own set. Although this is literally going... Okay. I understand. So here's the thing. We want to actually wait. I'm also trying to use these things more. The problem is we want to wait the system so that less are going. So here's actually how I'm going to do it. We're just going to send this one into here. And then we're going to send the rest into... We're going to send the rest into the other realm. That way we're always feeding this guy. You know, we only got four of these. So, I mean, this guy's always going to have more in the end. But I still think that's okay. Then, how do I want to split this? Well, we can do... So, this is it takes in from the other side. It still only splits to one output. Which is why this one is still valuable because it splits to two outputs. So we basically need it to come into here. Needs to come into here, come into here, come into here. Right? So what is the most efficient way to do that? It's probably going to be something like this in the end. But then it's going to split, split, split. And we're going to have it go, except you also need to do it here then, right? Because you basically need to find a way to bring, yeah, I'm understanding. Okay. I gotta figure out, there's definitely an efficient way to do this, but I don't know what it is yet. Okay. Because all of these need to have paths. Basically like this, right? But then how in the world do you split it in a nice even way that it makes sense how you're gonna curve it? And I think the easiest way to do that is with tunnels, right? So then that goes into there, but then you split and you do the same thing here with a tunnel that goes into here But then you're still missing one. So you do another split here with a path that leads to here. Okay. Now what? Right? Now what? Now you gotta get the blues. So you go basically here and you go split, wrap it over, tunnel to here and in. But then you also gotta figure out, well, how in the world are we gonna get more, right? So I think you go the tunnel like this and you split it here. And then this guy is just a tunnel from here to here to bring it in. Actually, now I'm looking at this and I'm going, heck, dude, we can make this way better. We can make this way better. Because instead, let's just have a splitter here with a tunnel that goes to here. And we basically run the... Oh, dude, I'm liking this idea, to be honest. Okay. Look, the game is all about efficiencies. I think you guys like watching me piece through this kind of crap. So really, I want to just bring... I just want to bring this across. Okay? And then we're just going to have various splits along the way to bring them into the various spots they need to be in. Like this. Okay? Then you just need things like this. Yo, I think this is clean as heck, brother. I think it's clean as heck. This is not a bad setup at all. I really hate that this is not. I'm going to actually move this now. Just so that it looks a little bit nicer. But this is so much more efficient. And now we're packing out green dye or teal dye like it's our job. And it's actually, it's getting backed up. We're making so much of it now. It's getting backed up. That's good. That's a good thing, for the record. Okay, so that's producing more. We got to start working on the actual objective today, which is getting white squares on a purple, or white circles on a purple square background. I actually don't think that's that bad to do. And I'm trying to think. I think right around here is where I want to do it too. Maybe over... I mean, we've got squares here, we've got blue dye, so we basically need to make a purple factory. Let me just double check. We got a purple factory up here. Okay. Yeah, not too interested in that. Actually, I think right here is even better. We got blue and red very close. I think this is absolutely where you do the purple factory. Okay, so similar setup as before. We'll go five deep on this one. In fact, dude, hold up. Because we might as well, it's down here. We might as well go control select. And then if I copy that. Cost 460 of those suckers. I don't care, to be honest. I'll paste this. Okay. Now, can I just move this? If I cut that... Wow, I'm a little mad, to be honest. I'm a little mad. Because that ended up costing way more than I wanted it to. But we can now... we can now pipe in... Oh, we can chain extract, by the way. This is something that y'all told me I was doing wrong, and I knew that there was definitely something off about it, since it was not doing that in the most efficient manner that we could ever do it. So if I do, like, does this work for chain extracting? Does this take out four? I mean, it's taken out a bunch, so I'm going to assume yes. So now that system is back up and working quite well. And then we just basically combine them. Will be very easy to do. Just like this. Beautiful, beautiful. And then just chain it to one. Okay, so now purple's being created. We've got white over here that we can snag. Now we need to figure out, we need to do... So the stacker puts the shape on top of the other. I need to make a better factory for these, by the way. That's going to be something that we work on as well. But okay, so we need to paint circles white. Which, to be fair, we have a lot of them, but we're gonna do more anyway. So let's split this, and let's bring this to here, and I'm gonna make the white circles here. We're gonna make the white squares here. We're gonna stack them here. So we need a good painter setup. So let's go. Basically, go 4 wide on this. And I think that we can actually afford to go 4 of these. Don't do a marker yet. And then we basically just got to get a good setup for this. So if we... Here's how I'm going to do it, okay? I want to split... I want to have 2 paths here, okay? I want to have 2 paths here. I want to bring them directly side by side. This one is going to feed these 2. This one's going to feed these 2. And by 2, I mean technically 4, but it works out in the end. So then this is going to split evenly up. And we're going to have 2 go that way. Right? But then we're also going to have... Yeah. And then that's going to split... To have, Yeah. Then that's gonna split. One of them's gonna go to here. One of them's gonna go to here. One to here. One to here. And I know you're sitting here going, Tyler, how the hell are you getting the circles in? We're gonna figure that out in a second, to be honest with you. But let's make this the exact same... Just like this, we're going to have a guy here, comes in, this goes over and in, this goes up, over and in. I know I'm not using any blueprints or anything, they're expensive as hell is the issue, so I don't necessarily want to go all in on that. But now that's feeding all those, then I just got to get the circles in. So where do we got circles? We got circles right here. So let's chain extract into a tunnel. And we're going to have this one feed these 2. And it's going to be as simple as bringing it over. Tunnel. And then we're going to do a split here. Over. Tunnel. And we're going to bring it directly in. Like so. Beautiful. And then this one's going to come down into a tunnel. And it's going to go over. New upgrade available, dude. We're speeding today. Into here with a combiner there. And then we should be able to just do something along... something along these lines. Make it look nice, right? We don't need to be animals. And that's going to give us a bunch of white squares. Okay. Then you do basically the same thing here. Get more chain extracts. You can do another 5, and that's totally okay. That goes to there. Comes over. And then you're just going to bring it down instead. Down instead to, like... Here, over, and in. This is so many white square circles, dude. I don't know why my brain is like, Let's just make a lot of everything. Which is the way to play this game, to be perfectly honest. You know, there's no reason to go small. You got infinite resources. So, there's that. And then once again, we combine. Bring it to there. Bring it to there. Combine. And we good. So now we have an entire factory for white circles. And it's the cleanest thing I think I've ever made in my life. Like, really good, to be honest. It's really good. In fact, I kind of want to, just to make it even cleaner. I kind of want to do... bring this to here. Just to make it even that little bit cleaner. So that it is perfectly symmetrical to the other side. Do this. Knock it in over. Just so that it's that much cleaner, right? Then, purple is being created, which is good. We're going to bring that this way. And we're going to have another painter set up down here, which is going to be close to the exact same thing that we just did. So up, down, four space, up, down, four space, up, down, four space, up, down. Beautiful. And then how are we going to feed those? It's quite simple. We're gonna do... See, this one's harder. So here's actually... We're gonna cut it here. Okay? This one's gonna feed top two. This one's gonna feed bottom two. That simple. So this one is going to... Those are backwards. Re-put them in. We need this to... go this way. So in, four space. In, four space. In, four space. In. Okay. Then, this comes over. No. This comes up. So we're going to be painting squares, right? So we're getting the squares from here. No, we're going to get the squares from here, probably. Just trying to find the most efficient way to do this. So let's go up with this, over, and then it's going to split here. One of them's going to cut down. I will tell you can do this with more space efficiency. I just think that it's honestly... maybe nicer to do it like this, just because you can kind of see what's going on a little bit better, which I think almost is nicer in the end. So then this is probably going to, let's set it up like this, right? It's a little messy, to be honest, but I think it works out okay in the end. Let's bring this all the way to here. Just trying to keep it exactly symmetrical with what we did above. So then it'd be here and here. This comes up. We can get rid of that right there. And then this goes a curve once into one of these. This comes over and in. This goes down over and in. Curve into one of these. Over and in, down, over and in. Dude, I'm making clean stuff today. This is super clean. I'm loving this a good deal. And the paints, it's coming. I'm hoping we're not going to need to make more of that, but if we have to, we have to. So then we're going to chain those. And frankly, I'm going to probably chain these the opposite direction. Okay, so combine that. This is going to come over into a tunnel and up. And it's a little janky to feed these systems, but I think it'll work. We're going to go a split here into here. Tunnel vision. This is a little bit janky, though. Let's tunnel it to here. Here, Because then we can go tunnel vision into here so that that gets fed. Then this one is the same. Tunnel vision into here. Beautiful. Oh, baby. Is good. And then this here, how do we want to... We want to have a split like this. Up. Tunnel vision. Over to here. Up. Tunnel vision. Into here. Feeding that. Okay. Then this one is the same thing. To here. Tunnel vision. Dude, I feel like I'm cracked out of my mind right now. This is so efficient. It's just looking so good. I did not expect to make something this nice today. In fact, I basically just bank on everything that I make in this game looking like somebody dropped a plate of spaghetti on the floor and then refused to clean it up for another like 15 years. It's like the people that have the spaghetti wall that they throw the spaghetti at to see whether or not it is done. That's how my builds in this normally feel. But this is, in fact, the greatest plays you've ever seen. Okay, so now we just have to make some stackers. Stackers are easy. So one, two, let's go three apart on these. And we're gonna set up a five system. I'm not even sure we're gonna be making enough to do a five system, but we're gonna try. So let's bring it. We have two here, actually. We'll combine those. This is going to run straight across. Like so. Then this is going to come up. And I actually am going to curve it a little bit. Because then this is going to run straight across. And actually, let's give it a little bit more space. I know that you just cried watching all of those go away. It's probably going to get cut like here, right? So then how am I going to get these into their respective places? Quite simple, okay? Although I'm now looking at it, and I know we're going to have efficiency issues, but that's okay. So we're going to have splits like this. Up, 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 okay? Then you're going to have same thing here. The straight line method, dude, works way better than you could ever hope it to. Like, this is clean. Now, I just really hope that we have this correct and we're stacking the right thing on top of the right thing, because I did not pay attention to that. Is this the shape? It's not. Son of a gun. Okay, start from scratch. Start from scratch. Because you've got it. A little bit messed up. Got a little bit messed up. You need this one to be here. In reality, it would be better to have the squares on top, but I think that's okay. But then that goes to there. This gets split here, then. Tunnel, tunnel. Tunnel, nope. Tunnel. Tunnel, tunnel. Tunnel. Stop. You keep on rotating. Tunnel, tunnel. Tunnel, tunnel. And then combine, 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 combine. Drag. Okay. And that goes up, that goes up, that goes up, that goes up. And these will make... That's... Yeah, okay. That's right now. That's right now. These come over and up, combine, combine, stop, combine, combine, over and up, combine, oh baby. Okay, so that's making that now, which is exactly what we want. We're going to bring it right up to here. A little dicier, to be honest. Don't really have a good entryway. So here's actually how I'm going to change this. We're going to bring this guy into here. We're going to bring this guy into here. And then say hello to your new entryway right here. And I'm actually going to bring it up this line. Because then that's going to cut straight up and will work very well for us. Straight into there. Oh, look at them funnel in, baby. Oh, that is some really good stuff. So, I mean, is it the fastest? I have another stacker here that I did not account for. And we can absolutely afford to do it. Let's put in another double stacker. Okay. I don't know why I just completely blanked on that one. But we can easily set this up. Once you have the system, it's kind of easy to add more to it. It's just whether or not we have enough white circles and stuff. But painting has gotten significantly faster for us recently. Got some upgrades for that rolling. So things have been good. They've been good. To here, up and in, outbound. We're going to go up and over, combine. And then frankly, dude, instead of trying to wrap that in over there, just combine them here. It's efficient. It's steady and efficient. When the only thing that you're losing, cutting, rotating, stacking, get upgraded, sucker. Oh, it's gonna move even faster now. Oh, baby. Those are actually flying in. That's borderline peak efficiency. It's really good. It's really good. I'm actually thrilled. I cannot be happier with this system and setup. In fact, I think we're actually going to start to see a slowdown. Yeah, we are starting to see a slowdown. We're not making purple squares fast enough. And also white circles fast enough. In fact, the white circles is even... It's because we don't have enough white dye, dude. Okay. Well, you know what? We can remedy that quite easily. Yeah, this system is not making nearly enough white dye. Okay, we should make a brand new white dye factory, I think. I think that's the next step. So here's how we're going to start, okay? Combine, 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 okay? And we are... No. I don't want to ruin this, but I'm going to, okay? Say goodnight. Goodbye. Goodbye. It's all gone. Okay, we can make it better. We can make it better. So, let's start with, we're going to stack reds and greens into one, okay? We're going to have two entryways for that, two entryways for this. And we're going to say, you go this way, you go this way. Those are going to go to a set of two color combiners. In fact, you could probably feed four color combiners with that. Okay. So then that's going to go one to here. This is alarming, what I'm trying to do here. Let's maybe rethink this. Okay. So if this goes to here, this goes to here, this goes to here. This goes to here with a split to go to here, right? Which is fine. And then obviously that's making yellow. But then getting the reds into here is a little bit harder. We can do it. It's just, do I need this to be the cleanest color mixer of all time? No. I just need it to be fast, to be perfectly honest. Then that's making yellow. We'd still need to get red up into here somehow. Which I frankly, I don't even think there's a way. I don't think there's a way to do that. Here's what I think we need to do, okay? I think we need to have mixers that are like something like this, right? One apart and then three apart. And then you need to basically run this to this one, this to this one, this to that one, this to this one, okay? And I'm gonna change it up a little. I'm gonna run those down like that. So then this comes down and you go, hello, split, one to here, one to here. And then you have this guy come in and you go, hi, we're gonna split once here into a tunnel that goes to here. We're gonna wrap it to there. We're gonna wrap it to there. Then this guy is gonna go, hello, I wanna go here. Send one to here, one to here. And you're gonna have this guy come up and it's gonna go, hi, I want to do one of these. One to here. Maybe not, right? Maybe not. Let's instead go one lower on this. And you're gonna go, hello, one to here, one to here, tunnel to here. Now you got four of these making yellow again, which is fine, totally fine. And we can work to combine these into a nice yellow pattern of war coming in. And then those yellows are going to feed a blue factory. And we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. Except let's even do it a little bit further up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that way, I mean, yellow's always going to be the issue. Unless we just continue to make a bunch more yellow going down, but I think that gets a little bit dicey in the end. So then we're going to wrap this around. We're going to go for straight line strats. That said, okay, hold up. Why not instead go 1, 2, 3, 4. And straight line strats works just as fine here. Right? And then you go high, split, high, split, and hello there, split. This goes in, this goes in, this goes in, this goes in. Then you just gotta get blues. Should be easy. Chain extract, come up, and I split into this, comes up into this, which will come up this, come up into that, split, split, this comes up, comes in, comes in, comes in, comes in. That's clean. That's definitely clean. Those come over. This comes down. This is going to make way more white than we were making before, dude. I mean, it's legitimately double what we were doing before. Which, I mean, I can't really be mad about it. That's a lot of white. It's gonna slow down a little bit. The problem is we're now the issue is actually we don't have enough painters. So I suppose let's get more of them in, right? You might as well keep going until you've reached peak efficiency. So this comes up, you have a combiner, one below like this. Goes in, goes in, goes in. And then you basically have the exact same setup again. So it should be like that. That goes over. That goes over. That goes over. And then this just changes to be like this. That changes to be like this. Like this. And like this. And then you got three more coming in now. Which is good. It's good. So then we should be able to use this now, right? So let's figure out how to use this. Yeah. That'll work. Because then that comes down into that. I haven't worked with these things a lot, these new compact boys. I still honestly like the other ones just more, which is why I used those ones. But I think this, I mean, this could look really cool if I use these combiners like this. And then it comes to here, you put one. Comes to here, you put one. Like this. Beautiful. It's a long video, I apologize. You come to here, and you put one. And then you come to here, and you put one. Look at how cool this looks, dude. Except I don't like how I'm bringing that up, to be honest. I'd much rather have them all in their lines, like so. And then we basically just, when we bring it into Sans, we do it like this. We go over and up. And now we're making a buttload of white dye. Is it continuous? That's the question of the hour. Boy, it feels continuous. In fact, I would argue it's even... No, we're going to see it slow shortly. Yeah, so here's the slow. It's not exactly continuous. But I think that we're at a point where... Adding another stacker might not be the move. I think it's probably good like this. Now, how is that translating to factories over here? This is getting white dye now. Pretty regularly. It still needs more. Although, honestly, it's getting backed up here. Why is this one not? Oh, because we split it early. So this is getting 50% of what we were getting before. I see. Okay. So this one's always going to have less white dye than this one. Because we split it 50%. So we can fix that, to be honest. It's basically called where we do this. And then we have a singular balancer here. To bring it to here. And then we just split it equally here. That way each side is getting equal. With 50% of the white going this way. 50% of the white going this way. That said. We don't need as much white going here. Like it's dumb to do that. So instead I want to actually... cut the amount of white going in that way. So now this is getting the majority of it. This is getting close to none of it. Well, I mean, right now it is quite literally getting none of it. But then what we can do is split again here. And I'm going to split it like this. And we're going to go around. And I know you're going, Tyler, this seems like a waste of your time. And it might be, to be honest with you. But allow me to explain what exactly this is doing. Also, please make this a nice, nice right angle. In fact, let me... It's not good if I'm getting, you know, very particular about this kind of movement. But here's the big difference right now to what we did with this setup. It's basically saying, hey, all of the white is going to come down into this system. Then 50% of... So it splits, right? 50% is going to here. 50% is going to here. Then we say, hey, 50% of this 50%. So 25% of what came to here. Is also going to go this way. And 25% of what came to here is also going to go this way. Which in the end means that... Wait a minute. I think my logic is maybe skewed. And we still don't have enough white dye in the end. And this is still getting backed up. So I actually think you cut this. Right? Cut this. But then add a load balancer here. And that way, maybe it helps to keep as much going as possible. I think in the end, I just need more white dye, man. I think we made this whole setup over here, and this still ain't enough. And white or yellow is now not producing enough. So I basically need to make another one of these. Which we could do. It's basically as easy. We copy this. Right? We get another one of them here, and then we just have to feed it resources. Okay, so then this has to be red, this has to be red. So let's get red going here. And we're going to basically load balance it to send reds to there. Like so. And then reds to here. Like so. And then greens, we got to do the same thing. Like this. We're going to send one basically down to here. We're going to send it into this system. Beautiful. And then also into this system. And that one's going to get wrapped around like this. And now we just doubled our yellow production again. Which I think is obviously important. Yellow is the biggest issue that we have right now. I mean, we could actually use a compact balancer. I'm going to try to get used to using these. Just because I know that they save a little bit of space. But now, I mean, that's significantly more yellow. Like a crazy amount more yellow, actually. I would argue that it's so much yellow we can afford to get more stackers. Is that true? Yeah, it is. Yeah, that's backing up. We can get more stackers. Sure, dude. Let's get more stackers. I think two more is probably sufficient. I like this setup like a ton, by the way. I think it's really good. Let's get this back. This goes up and over. This continues up with a buddy here, in, and then it's as simple as getting tunnel here to here, up and over this here. Now those are making, and we can go down like this into a, well, how do I want to do this? It won't look as pretty because the system we made is now, there we go, like this. The system we made is now a little bit jankier than before, but we can just load balance it like this. Why? Oh, I put in freaking stackers instead of painters, dude. I'm a dummy. But now we're making more white off of that. We could probably add more. I'm looking at it, I'm like, we can probably add more. So I'm just going to keep on adding more until this system slows down. I kind of don't see a reason not to. What did I do wrong here? This is one below. One below. Comes up. Over. No, I didn't do anything wrong. This goes up. This goes up. You might as well just prep this for the future since it's going to need to be. It's going to need to be like this anyway. That goes over. That's there. This goes over. Those are now filling up. And then this is just an easy combine here. Load balancer. Like so. Down into a larger balancer right here. And now, I mean, we're making white dye like crazy. I feel like it's still not. It's actually. That's a steady flow now. That's a steady flow. I think we're not making as much yellow now. Yeah. So yellow's the backup again. But. Yeah, okay. So it's still a little. It's not the most efficient. We would need to produce more yellow again. Now, here's the wild thing, right? Well, no, not necessarily. That won't work. Yeah, okay. I was going to suggest something, but that ain't going to work. We could get more yellow. It's just a matter of more copy and paste, but yeah. Definitely, we don't have enough yellow to produce that efficiently. But we could get more, except this is backing up, dude. So we actually are at peak efficiency now. So just that little bit more white was enough. So, I mean, look, if it's efficient over here, it's enough white for now. We can always make a massive white factory in the future to make it work the best. But this is working. This is working efficiently. We're dumping in. We've already got 4,200 of these put in. It's a pretty efficient system. Purple squares is the issue, actually. Really? So the issue is purple dye at this point. Weird. We can get more. I'm never gonna stop, by the way, if I don't end the video soon. So we are gonna do that soon. But I'm gonna copy this and we're gonna throw it here. And then I just need to get blue dye over here, red dye over here. We got red dye sitting right here. So let's just do one of these. And we're gonna send it directly into this. So red dye into there. And then we're gonna get a chain extract on blue dye to go up this way. And I'm gonna make it look nice. Now blue dye is going into there, and we got more purple dye again. And we're just going to send it down this way. Probably the most disgusting path I've ever made. Send it like so to here, and we're going to do a nice little chain boil lip like this. And that way it's sending... Well, that's gonna... Oh. I understand. That's now overloading the system a little bit. Wait, look. I'm making this as a temporary change. We can make this cleaner in the future by having the purple just feed for one section. But we might as well share the welfare a little bit here. This is going to absolutely fill up the purple here, and then we'll be back to peak efficiency. I mean, we basically are producing 8 purple dye now. We were producing 4 before. You can see it's filling up, which means the squares are going to start to fill up. And once the squares start filling up, dude, then you're back at extreme peak efficiency, and this thing's going to fly. It's going to take a little bit of time. It's taking a little bit of time to fill up, but you can see it's just watch these ones. You're slowly getting, it's like now it's at 3. You're gonna, in a little bit, you're gonna see it hit 4. I think it might take a little bit of time for these to fully fill, but it's, yeah, now you're at 4. But I think over time this might be efficient enough. But we can always add more painters. In fact, I could probably fit... I just made a mistake. What did I just undo, dude? I killed a painter. I meant to copy a painter, but I'm dumb. There we go. So we can go control select this, right? Copy that, and we're going to just fit another one. How do I want to... Is this? No, it'd be here. No, it'd be here? What? How am I doing this? It'd be here. That we need another one. I think. And then... This would come down to here. But then where do I need to send this stuff up? So this goes up. That's doing that. And then I just need to get the squares in. How did I make this, dude? Why is this breaking me? The squares come up like so. I suppose we could do it like this. And then this goes up into a tunnel here. That works, I guess. I think it's a little bit messy, but we'll make it work. But that I mean, that's two more squares now in the system as well. I think it's good. This is now filled. These extra squares should help the efficiency of this. I mean, this is a lot of these that we're rolling in. We're up to 6,000 now. In due time, that's going to be done, which is very exciting. But that's going to do it for today. Holy crap, I recorded this for a long time. 50-minute episode. My bad. Thanks so much for watching. I don't know how much more Shapes.io we're going to do, so if you love the series, then please let me know so that I can continue to make it. I enjoy this game a lot, but I also understand it's a very niche area on YouTube, I think. But you guys seem to be loving it, so if you love it, I'll continue it. But I also know there's other games in the sea to play. So let me know. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. You have a good rest of your day. Bye-bye.